state leaders, including the governor and the leaders of the state assembly and the state senate, are not taking a formal position on any of this, and they're not publicly taking sides, despite the constant demonstrations in and around this building urging them to. Now, the 19 state lawmakers that are part of the Legislative Jewish Caucus sent a letter to President Biden urging him to continue prioritizing the health and safety of Israeli hostages held by Hamas. The group wrote, in part, "The last 65 days have brought extraordinary pain and anguish to so many families in our Jewish community who are desperate for the release of loved ones who are currently being held captive in Gaza. We believe that ensuring the speedy and safe release of these hostages must remain a top priority." And today, just a few blocks away from here at the federal courthouse in Sacramento, pro-Palestinian groups held a demonstration calling for a ceasefire in Gaza. This is one of several Palestinian demonstrations that supporters have held around state government or state government events. Groups shut down the state's Democratic convention last month and also dissuaded the governor from having a live and in-person Capitol Christmas tree lighting ceremony last week. The group today wanted to send a message to California's U.S. Senator Alex Padilla.
We're here to call on Senator Padilla to vote for a ceasefire and a stop to the $14 billion aid to Israel. Right now, the genocide in Gaza is decimating the whole land, and thousands of people have been killed. Fights so hard for immigrant communities here in the U.S., and he should align his values with the moral majority of the United States to protect people in Palestine and commit to a ceasefire.
We reached out to U.S. Senator Alex Padilla's office in Washington, D.C. for a response or comment in response to that demonstration, but we have not yet heard back. Meanwhile, closer to home here at the state capitol, we know a group of legislative staffers are circulating a letter to those who work in and around this building, urging for their bosses to call for a ceasefire. But again, state leaders are not commenting. Reporting at the state capitol, Ashley Zavala, KCRA 3 News.
That letter circulated by state capitol staffers is in the form of a Google Doc, and those who sign it are anonymous.